हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द पोएट्री सेक्शन फ्रॉम द पोएट्री सेक्शन ऑफ नॉर्थविल द फर्स्ट पोएम वी विल नो अ फोटोग्राफ अ फोटोग्राफ हैज बीन रिटन बाय शिर्ली टाउसन Littleton has composed it very beautifully. In this poem, the poet describes how deeply she feels the loss of her mother. Her mother has now been dead for more than 12 years. The poetess recalls how her mother used to look at a photograph and remember her own childhood when that photograph was taken. The mother was just a girl of about 12 years old. The photograph shows the mother with two of her girl cousins on a sea beach. All the three girls were smiling at the uncle who was taking their pictures. The mother would show this photograph to be the mark of the past. She would show these pictures to the poetess and talk of those happy days. She would laugh in the picture while talking of that sea holiday. But a great change had come in the mother by that time. She was now a middle-aged woman and had the poetess as a daughter. All her former liveliness was gone. Recalling her mother, the poetess says the sea holiday was her past, mine is her love. The poetess intensely feels the loss of her mother. She remembers how the mother used to talk to her and laugh. But now that laughter is a thing of the past. The mother has been dead for about 12 years. The poetess feels very sad and lonely. She says that now she is in situation where there is nothing to say at all. It is all emptiness for her. It has killed all feelings in her. The silence of her situation has silenced her to a death-like silence. So dear students, then the book will explain all the stanzas. The first stanza: the cardboard shows me. Cardboard here, I skip. Paperboard shows me how it was when the two girl cousins went paddling. Here girl cousins, girls who were the daughters of an uncle and aunt. Paddling here, walking with the bare feet in shallow water. Each one holding of my mother's hands, and the big girl some 12 years or so. All three stood still to smile through their hair, still moving, without moving, sir. Motionless. All three stood still to smile through their hair. Because of the wind, their hair flew over their faces. At the uncle with the camera, a sweet face, my mother's, that was before I was born. And the sea which appears to have changed less, washed their terribly transient feet. Transient feet. Transient, very short time. Here the poetess says that she is looking at a photograph. It is the photograph of her mother. In it she can see how her mother looked when she was a little girl. At that time her mother was about 12 years old. The photograph shows her on a beach. She was with her. She was with her two cousins at the seashore. The cousins are younger in age. Each one is holding one of her mother's hands. It must be windy at that time. The wind was blowing. That was why their hair was flying on their faces. All three were smiling through their hair. In the other words, we can say their smiling faces could be seen under their flying hair. They were smiling at the uncle who had a camera and was taking their photograph. Looking at the photograph, the poetess says that her mother had a sweet face, but it was of time. It was of time before she was born. The poetess was born. The three girls were standing in the sea. The sea was washing their feet. The poetess says that the sea has changed little since then, but a terrible change has come about those whose feet was washed. Next step. Some 20, 30 years later, she laughed at the snapshot. Snapshot means photograph. See, Betty and Dolly, she'd say, and look how they dragged us for the beach. The sea holiday was her past. Mine is her, both right with the labored ease of love. Try to stay. Sea holiday, mother often remembered the joy of that sea holiday, but it was for her a thing of the past. Betty and Dolly are the cousins of the poetess. Labored ease of loss, a feeling of relief. after 20 or 30 years when she was in her 30s or 40s. The mother would take out that photograph and look at it. By that time she had been married and had the poetess as her daughter. She would look at the photograph and laugh on it. She would say to the poetess, "Look at Betty and Dolly. Look how they had dressed us for the beach." Thus the mother would remember that sea holiday of hers. But now all that was a thing of the past. Now a lot had changed for the mother. She no longer had those sweet joys of her childhood. However, the poetess remembers that little laughter of her mother, and for her that laughter has become a thing of the past. Now a lot has changed for her. She can't even see the laughing face of her mother. The mother has died. That was why the poetess says, "The sea holiday was her past, mine is her now." Just as the mother's face had turned, mother's face had turned twisted with the expression of unhappiness. And for her that laughter has become a past. Mother's face had the unhappiness. She had lost the innocent joys of her childhood. So the poetess feels unhappiness after losing the joys of her mother's company. However, in course of time, both of them learned to live with their loss. The poetess calls this the labored ease of love. The pain of this loss left a permanent impression on their unhappy faces, twisted faces. Both of them are worried. They have twisted faces. Now the next thing. Now she is being dead nearly as many years. Many years since the poetess mother has been dead for as many years, about 12 years. As that girl lived, and of this circumstance, as that girl lived, the mother lived a happy life till she was a girl of about 12. Of this circumstance means the present situation when the poetess has been living so long without her mother. There is nothing to say at all. It's silence, silence. There is nothing to at all. Silence, silence. The loss is too big to say anything. The intensity of the loss, silence, silence, the intensity of the loss is too big to say anything. Sorry. The intensity of the loss has left the poetess speechless. It has killed all our feelings. So let's come to know. Now she's been dead nearly as many years as that girl lived. End of this circumstance, there is nothing to say at all. It's silence, silence, silences. The poetess says that her mother has been dead for as many years as the girl in that photograph had lived. The girl had lived for about 12 years and then she grew up into womanhood. The poetess means to say that her mother has been dead for about 12 years and now she feels herself in such a situation that there is nothing to say about it. There is nothing but emptiness. The silence of the situation, the silence of the situation silences. In other words, her loss has left her speechless. It has killed all feelings. Now, here are some stanza-wise questions. You will give the answer. What does the cardboard denote? What is the answer? What does the cardboard denote? You will write that cardboard denotes the photograph which showed the poetess's mother and her two girls. Next, who were the two girls? They were the cousins of the poetess. Who has been said to be the girl, to be the big girl? Who is big girl? The poetess mother has been said to be the big girl. She was older and taller than the other girls. What did the cardboard show? Cardboard showed three girls walking with bare feet in the shallow water of the sea. What did the cardboard show? Cardboard shows the three girls walking with bare feet in the shallow water of the Tell me. Explain again. What do you mean by its silence silences? It means the loss of our mother is too deep for the poetess. Now she has nothing to say at all. The silence of her loneliness has silenced or killed all her